open eyes and walk into the light. Cause I've been sleeping way too long. Ooh, this blurry vision had me living blind. Show me what's really going on. The world is in here right now. It's time to let love be loud. We gotta be what we preach about.
And welcome to the Church Basement. I'm Paul, and this is my YouTube channel where we play songs that I played at church recently, and I tell you how I played them. So today's song is Make a Difference by Danny Gokey. It's a fun song with a lot going on in the chorus. It's very repetitive in the chorus, but it's lots of fun. The song has basically three parts. It has a verse part, a pre-chorus part, and then a chorus part. There is sort of a bridge twice. So after the second chorus and before the third chorus, there's a line that says, if we change our heart, we can change the world. We got to take a step or we'll never know. What are we waiting for? And in that section, just play what you're playing through the chorus basically anyways, except there's a stop on waiting for before it comes back into the chorus part. And there is another bridge towards the end, but it's actually more it's everybody but the bass. So you don't play at anything there. So yeah, we're just not going to talk about it. Now, I'm going to talk about the verse and the pre-chorus together. But keep in mind, the first time through, you don't play the intro and you don't play the verse. So you come in on the pre-chorus in the first verse. But the other time you do play the verse part. The verse part starts on an E. The pattern is E, F sharp, G sharp, E, F sharp, B, E, F sharp, G sharp, E, F sharp. And then that gets you to the pre-chorus. Coming off of that F sharp, there's a passing B to an F sharp, and then G sharp, E, and then F sharp. So what that verse looks like is this. this is the pre-chorus. Okay, so it's just those chords, and they're really just whole notes for the most part. The second time you play that pattern on the pre-chorus, when he gets, gotta be what we preach about, or it's actually, and let them know what we're all about the second time, but you basically hit that F sharp twice, and then you go into the chorus part. So the chorus part is kind of fun. It sounds like this. So that's E, B, E, E, C sharp, E flat, F sharp, C sharp, F sharp, G sharp. And honestly, if you can figure that out, it's basically the whole song. So in the chorus, usually the second time through on the F sharp, you don't go to that G sharp. So it just becomes. And that's basically it. If you wanted to, you can also play just on the bottom true string. So you could do it like, instead of going up to here. But for some reason, I seem to like going up on the third string. So that's really the whole song. It's actually not a particularly tricky song to learn once you've got that chorus riff down. Getting it to sound like the album, when that's a bit more challenging and requires a little bit of sitting there with an EQ and figuring things out. But otherwise, it's pretty easy. If you want to see the live version, you can click up here, because that's where the live version will be. And otherwise, I hope you're having a great time, and have fun and keep playing bass.